Hello everyone. I am in Boston right now. I've had a very, very exciting week that I would like to share with you. So today is going to be more of a story time kind of video. So if you're here for something more serious, then I'm sorry. You can come back next week when I will be uploading a very interesting video about the future of construction, generative design. I've interviewed some very interesting people on that. But today I just wanted to relax, sit back and reflect on the week that I've had. So I am in the United States because I got invited to Autodesk University in Las Vegas. If you don't know what that is, it is a massive event organized by Autodesk each year. There are like presentations by the most amazing people on all the like hot topics that are going on in the industry at the moment. There is a huge expo where everything innovative is showcased with all the companies and startups that display what they developed. And I got invited to attend at that event, which I was very excited about. So, since obviously from Berlin, where I currently live, to Las Vegas, it's a very long trip, I thought, why not make the most of it and spend the weekend before and the weekend after in the United States as well. So, my plan was like this. Fly to New York, spend the weekend there, enjoy the city, then go to Las Vegas, where the program started on Monday with Forge DevCon, which is an event for all the like developers that work with Forge or that are interested in working with Forge. Then Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Autodesk University, so the conference, and then fly to Boston and then spend a couple of days there to cool off and to visit the build space. So yeah, and then head back home to Berlin. So I think what dominated the first half of my trip was definitely the story of my lost luggage. So if you follow me on Instagram, you might already like heard about it, but let me tell you how this went. On Friday morning, I started my trip, my flight to the US, to JFK in New York. And I didn't have a direct flight, so I had to go from Berlin to Düsseldorf and then Düsseldorf at JFK. And they told me they would check my luggage through so that I didn't need to worry about it, like after I got on the first plane and it would arrive with me in New York. So, but when I got off the plane in New York, I was very, very excited because I've never been to New York before. I was very excited to be in such a big city and to spend the weekend there. But I think I never went from super hyper to sad so quick because my luggage didn't arrive with me. And I mean, you can imagine that after you've spent, I think like 13 hours traveling, you would very much like to change and to also, I wanted to, of course, look beautiful in New York. So I was not super happy that I didn't have any clothes with me. But the good thing was that I didn't stay in a hotel in New York, but I stayed with friends of Alex, who I met at AU London, which you might remember from my interview with him with the VR goggles and everything. So, yes, I stayed with this couple who were really, really nice, and the woman had kind of the same figure as I have, so she gave me some of her clothes, which was really nice, and they had an extra toothbrush and everything, so that I would be able to go out to New York on Saturday. Of course, I had to visit the Guggenheim Museum. I loved the exhibition there, and of course also the architecture. I mean, the whole trip to the city was just amazing because you see all these places that you know from movies or from I don't know, pop culture, and then you're actually there and see the Empire State Building and Brooklyn Bridge and Manhattan, the Chrysler Tower. I used to be a massive Gossip Girl fan, so being suddenly in, like, seeing all these places in real life, and you know, also from How I Met Your Mother, that was very good. It got me really excited going to Chinatown, Grand Central Station, Little Italy. I mean, yeah, no, I have to say I really, really enjoyed being in New York. I had a very good day. I wish I had a bit more time because, unfortunately, because of the issue with my luggage, I had to spend quite some time going shopping, which sounds like something you shouldn't complain about. But I mean, the shops are so international now. There are hardly any brands that I couldn't go shopping for in Europe. So I have to say it was not like the, oh, I'm going shopping in New York, it's so exciting, getting to buy all these things that I couldn't get at home. I mean, it's not like that anymore. So it was more of it felt more like a duty then. I didn't have enough time then to go to the MoMA, which I would have liked to do. So I definitely have to go back. But I still very, very much enjoyed it. And thanks again to Ian and Lindsay to letting me stay with them. So, okay, arrived in Las Vegas, very nice hotel, very much impressed by the hugeness of the city. I mean, it's very, very overwhelming. All the lights and all the sounds, and like when you get into a casino, it's just like beep, 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 and like lights flashing from everywhere. So that was a bit much in the beginning, but I got used to it throughout the week. Plus the, the conference was in a like much calmer space. And I was there with the student ambassador team from Autodesk, which is a group of students who are like experts in using one of the Autodesk software. So in my case, Revit, and others who use Fusion or Inventor, who have gained some recognition by Autodesk because they either like started teaching their fellow students or they participated in some kind of program from Autodesk. I think everybody has a different story of how they ended up there. So if you feel like you want to be involved with that, go check out the, go research it on the Autodesk website, and you can like enter things that you have done and then you might reach some like student expert status. To continue the story of my lost luggage, so I was told that my luggage, oh, by the way, the reason I didn't get my luggage, oh, I didn't get into that before, was because it stayed in Düsseldorf. And there was no flight to, so I arrived on Friday evening in New York, and there was no flight from Düsseldorf to JFK on Saturday. So they told me it would arrive on Sunday with the next flight in JFK. But it arrived at a time when I already had to get on my plane to Las Vegas. So I gave them the address of my hotel in Las Vegas and they told me they would send it there and deliver it to my hotel. So I was expecting it to be there at like Monday midday, but I guess that was a bit optimistic to expect it to be like delivered and taken care of right away. So on Tuesday I got a bit fed up of like having to wear the same, I mean, I only bought two outfits in New York and that was Saturday and now it was already Tuesday, still had to wear the same clothes again. So I was getting a bit fed up, to be honest. And then I called again Tuesday morning and asked what the state of my luggage was, and they gave me a shipping number so that I could follow on the process online. And there I saw that it was already like in Las Vegas. It had arrived there like 2 hours ago and would probably be delivered to my hotel around noon. So I was pretty relieved to hear that and went to the conference and during the day I got the email that it had been delivered to my hotel. So I was very happy to finally having resolved this issue and being able to go out in the evening and wear something different. So when the conference was over, I made plans for dinner and went to the hotel and was like very happy to finally have my luggage bag and put on some fresh clothes. But when I arrived at the concierge desk, they told me that because it wasn't delivered with the airline but with FedEx, it wasn't brought to the concierge desk but to the post office, I guess, and that had already closed, and like I should come back at 7:30 in the morning. So at this point I was literally like, I'm going to lose my mind over this stupid luggage issue. Because I mean, it's not only about clothes, I don't want to sound superficial, but it was just annoying to, I just wanted to have this issue resolved and not worry about it anymore. Plus I had my camera equipment in the bag, so I wasn't able to film much before then. I think they could tell that I was about to have like a mental breakdown, so they I was able to convince them to give me my luggage, and they managed to find somebody who had a key to the like post office storage room, and I got like finally got my luggage, was reunited with my clothes and my stuff, and did like, and this issue was finally resolved. So I was very happy about that. So let me tell you a bit more about the actual conference now. As I said, it was huge. I've never been to an event that big before. 13,000 people who were attending, and I heard there were 2,000 sessions to choose from. So a session would be a presentation, a course, or like a actual like hands-on tutorial. I mean, it was obviously not only for construction, because Autodesk also has software for design, like industrial design and production and fabrication, but there was a lot about construction and architecture actually. And even though the event was so big, in the actual like sessions that you would go to, it would never be like too many people. It would be like a good atmosphere that you would actually be able to ask questions or talk to the speaker afterwards if you wanted to. So yeah, I think they balanced that out quite well. And as I said, I was involved with the education team from Autodesk, the student ambassador group that was there, and there were some events that were especially designed for us. For example, we got to, each one of us got to present 60 seconds in front of a selected group of Autodesk executives that wanted to get to know us. So that was an awesome opportunity, and also it was interesting for me to hear about what the other students do. I mean, that is my overall takeaway from the event, I have to say. That I didn't expect it. I mean, it is organized by Autodesk, it's called Autodesk University, so I guess I expected it to be a bit more commercial, but it is actually, and this is like my honest opinion, I was really surprised by how relevant it is, because there were so many like people, like there was just everybody from the field of like BIM and computational design and this whole like digitalization field inside of the AEC world, that I was like, I met literally everyone that I already knew online because I follow their blog or I follow their Twitter or I've met them in some kind of way like LinkedIn and exchanged ideas with them or just followed them and admired their work. So literally everyone I knew was there, and every like hot topic that there is at the moment was covered throughout the conference and discussed. And so even though it is organized by a company, it really felt more like a just general opportunity to exchange ideas with other people and discuss problems and like find solutions or like see what other people have been up to and get up to date with all the developments that are going on at the moment. So yes, that is my general takeaway from the conference. So yeah, as I said, the most interesting part of it was to meet all these very cool people. I did an interview with Kian Wemsley, if you didn't know him. He had a presentation about generative urban design that I found very inspiring. So I grabbed him for an interview that is going to be uploaded next week. And then time flew by, really. On Wednesday evening, there was a huge party organized by Autodesk to because it was the last night of the conference. And as I said, 13,000 people there, so you can't just rent like one bar to accommodate everybody. But Autodesk actually blocked a whole street in Las Vegas and rented all the bars and restaurants that are there and threw a party there. And you could just go to any kind of bar, walk around. I also went on the Ferris wheel, on which you can overlook all of Las Vegas. That was amazing because you could like see as far as the border of Las Vegas, behind which it is just pitch black at night because it's the desert. And yeah, now I'm in Boston. Visited the Bill Space yesterday, which is a laboratory for like people from the AEC industry who want to develop a product or test something so they can apply to work there and use the machines there. And if they get accepted, they can use the space and all the machines for free and do whatever they want. And then today I got to relax a bit, calm down after those exciting days in Las Vegas. I saw a bit of Boston. I went to the Museum of Fine Arts in Boston, which has the biggest art collection in the world. I didn't know that before. It was very interesting. It had a whole wing